In this video, I'll be showing my new island in Roblox Island. So I spent about 8 hours yesterday with a whole bunch of my friends completely redoing my island. So in the very beginning, I was going to do a video about giving everyone builds and destroying my island, but most people ended up making super high up towers and that did not end well. So now I just reset my island and then I spent 8 hours with a lot of my friends building this, but now I have a bedrock. Before I didn't have a bedrock. If you made your island or if you started playing islands within like the first few days of release, then you wouldn't have a bedrock and it would save like that. But the first part of my island is the spawn. So it just has iron and gold blocks and a bedrock in the very middle. And also it has conveyors on the top just to give it kind of like a metal design. And it looks kind of like a gate maybe because it has this gold gate thing in the front. But then I have my portal here, which I don't have anything behind it, but I might add a stairway behind it again, like my old island, and there might be a storage level under that. But the only problem is this island is at like 47.5k blocks, and the limit is 50k blocks. So if they increase the block limit, then I'll be able to add an island layer under this, and then it's just going to be like this size, but it's just going to be all storage. And then over here, I have my bee farm, which whenever I get more flower seeds, I'm going to make this bigger. But for now, I just have all of these trees, and I'm waiting for some of the hives to spawn on the other ones. Right now, I only have 3 hives, and I have about like 10 or 15 bees total. And then over here, I have my area where I can craft things and do other things. This is just where I keep all of the stations. Yeah, that's all of the downstairs part. Now I have the stairway. Later I might just destroy this entire stairway and make it over here so that whenever you go over here, instead of going along the wall of the stairway and having to go in, the start of the stairway will just be right here and then you can just walk in and go up over here. But that will also be closer to the edge in the corner over there instead of just like in the first half of the entire upstairs. But then the stairway ends right here. And then this is the stone level. So I don't know what I'm going to use it for. Let me know in the comments what you think I should use it for. Maybe I could use this as storage. But like I mentioned in my last video on Twitter, Island said they're working on increasing the limit of blocks that can be dropped. And it looked like they're going to make it around like 1,000 or more. So that means auto farms will be way better. So I might make a few auto farms on this level, like an auto farm for iron, an auto farm for stone, maybe a few other auto farms. But I know how to make an auto farm to give 2 million a day of whatever you want that can be dropped from totems. Probably a little bit less for iron though, because that also has to go through a smelter. But I might show that again. I've showed it in 2 different videos and it's just super overpowered. But I might make a few auto farms like that so that I can just get a whole bunch of stone and iron and stuff. But the limit for almost every block is 1 million, so I'll only be able to farm until I get that much. I know this took forever to build, but if the block limit is increased, I'm going to just reset the entire island again and do everything all over again. Because my plan was originally, if there's no block limit, to make this go to the very edges of the island, and it would just like be so huge, and it would be maybe 200 blocks tall, because right now it's 25 blocks tall. So all of the walls together on this level are 10k blocks, the floor is 10k blocks, that floor is 10k blocks, and the wall of that floor is 10k blocks. So in total, that's 40k. The stairway is about maybe 5k, I think. And then all of the other stuff is maybe around like 1k. So I can still place a few thousand more blocks. I'm not exactly sure what I should do with that though. Really hope the block limit is increased though, because so this is just my total goal. So it would be around the entire max area that you can build your base, and it would be 200 blocks high, and there would be probably like 50 to 100 levels. Now that would be extremely huge, and it would take forever, but I just think that would be really cool to do. The next level will be wood, then iron, then gold, then probably sand, gravel, and basically just every type of block existing in the game I'll try to make a level for if I can, if the block limit is higher. Yeah, I guess that was the island tour. My island is pretty big right now, but there's not really that much to show because I haven't really done anything with the second level, and all I have are like four things on the first level. So that's my island right now. I'm probably not going to build any houses or anything unless if they increase the block limit a lot, because since the block limit is kinda low right now, I don't want to build something for decoration and then they add something important that I could use and then I won't have enough blocks to build it. So I'm just saving the rest of the block limit for something important that they might add later. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments what should I use the stone level for, because I'm still not really sure what I should use it for. But make sure to subscribe with the notifications on for daily islands videos, like the video, join the Discord server and Roblox group links in the description for trading and talking about Roblox Islands, and follow my Twitter at Telanthric. I'm trying to hit 2k followers there and 200k subscribers on YouTube. Also, there's a playlist linked in the description. It has everything that you'd need to know in Roblox Islands, so I recommend if you need help with anything to check that and it will probably be there. But I'll see you all in the next video. Bye, YouTube.